For decades, Western observers have sought to pinpoint the root causes of such sentiments, convincing themselves that the more extreme statements are partly metaphorical and that a renunciation of policy or of past Western conduct, such as American and British interference in Iranian domestic politics in the 1950s, might open the door to reconciliation. Yet revolutionary Islamism has not, up to now, manifested itself as a quest for international cooperation, as the West understands the term. Nor is the Iranian clerical regime best interpreted as an aggrieved post-colonial independence movement waiting hopefully for demonstrations of American goodwill. Under the Ayatollah's concept of policy, the dispute with the West is not a matter of specific technical concessions or negotiating formulas, but a contest over the nature of a world order. Even at a moment hailed in the West as auguring a new spirit of conciliation, after the completion of an interim agreement on Iran's nuclear program with the five permanent members of the Security Council plus Germany, the Iranian Supreme Leader Khamenei declared in January 2014, "By dressing up America's face, some individuals are trying to remove the ugliness, the violence, and terror from this face and introduce America's government to the Iranian people as being affectionate and humanitarian. How can you change such an ugly and criminal face in front of the Iranian people with makeup? Iran will not violate what it agreed to, but the Americans are enemies of the Islamic Revolution. They are enemies of the Islamic Republic. They are enemies of this flag that you have raised." Or, as Khamenei put it somewhat more delicately in a speech to Iran's Guardian Council in September 2013, "When a wrestler is wrestling with an opponent and in places shows flexibility for technical reasons, let him not forget who his opponent is."